Hey girls, so we just finished up talking about how to graph an equation of a linear function. So given the equation y equals 4x minus 1, you should be able to graph this line based on the fact that this is in the form of y equals mx plus b. So looking here at our equation, our slope is 4, and our y-intercept is negative 1. So the first thing I'm going to do is graph my y-intercept. My y-intercept is negative 1, which means that I'm going to go on the y-axis down to 0, negative 1. My slope is the rise over the run. So the coefficient in front of x is 4. And I have to write that 4 as a fraction. So that would give us 4 over 1, which would mean that I would rise up 4 and to the right 1. And I'm going to do that from the only point I have on my graph so far, which is the y-intercept. So from the y-intercept, I'm going to count up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and go over to the right 1. And there is my second point. Once I have two points, I can then draw my line. So given an equation in y equals mx plus b form, I'm able to graph the equation of that line. But now, what if we were given the slope and the y-intercept? Could we go backwards and write the equation of the line? So what if I was given the graph? If I was given the graph, could I go backwards and write my equation? Well, we certainly can. So to do this, of course we have to, as usual, let's start off with what the y-intercept is. Y-intercept is the point at which the graph crosses the y-axis. Our graph crosses the y-axis right here. And that point is 0, 1, 2. So our y-intercept is 2. The next thing we need to do is find the slope. The slope, as we said, is the rise over the run. And the way we find the rise over the run when we're given a graph is we are going to first count from one point to the other point. We're going to count how many blocks up and then how many boxes to the left or to the right. In this case, the right. So our rise is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my rise is 6 and my run is 1, 2. So this is 6 over 2, which can be reduced to 3 over 1, which is simply 3. Okay? So once I know my slope and my y-intercept, I can plug that into my formula. Y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope. So instead of writing m, I'm going to write my slope. And my y-intercept is 2, and it's positive. So that is the equation of this graph. Y equals 3x plus 2. Let's do another one. Okay, let's say I was given the following graph. following graph, can you write the equation of this line? By looking at the graph, we know that we're going to have to find the slope and the y-intercept in order to write the equation of this line. And looking at this graph, we can read off both the slope and the y-intercept. Let's first look at the y-intercept. The y-intercept is the point at which the graph crosses the y-axis. So I'm going to count down 1, 2. One, two, three, four, five. I went down 5. So my y-intercept is 0, -5. The next thing I need to do now is find the slope. The slope is the rise over the run. So to calculate the rise over the run, I'm going to count how many boxes up and how many boxes to the left, which is my run. So let's count. My rise is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. My run, I'm going to start from here, 1, 2, 3. Now, since I went to the left, my run is negative. So therefore, my slope is -8/3. Once I have my slope and my y-intercept, I can now write the equation of this line. y=mx + b. y=my slope is m, so my slope is -8/3. Times x. Now my y-intercept is -5. So instead of this being plus b, it's going to be minus. And this is the equation of the line that was graphed from the beginning. So you should be able to work both ways. You should be able to, if given an equation y=mx + b, you should be able to read off the slope and the y-intercept. And you should be able to work in the reverse. If given the equation, can you work backwards and find the slope and the y-intercept? So here's one to try on your own. Let's see if you can do this one. Hit pause, and then check back to see the answer. So now you've joined us back in after hitting pause. Let's see if you can write the equation of this line. Remember, the equation of a line is y=mx + b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So let's calculate, or let's read off, the y-intercept and the slope from this graph. Let's first start off with the y-intercept. The y-intercept is the point on the graph that crosses the y-axis. This is our y-intercept. So if we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, our y-intercept is at 0, 5. The next thing we need to calculate is the slope. The slope is the rise over the run. So to calculate the rise, I first want to see I'm going to go to my y-intercept and I'm going to count how many places up until my next point. That's the rise. The run is how many points over to the left or to the right. So in this case, my rise is 1, 2. And my run from this point right here is 1, 2, 3, four, five, six, seven, eight. So my rise was 2 and my run was 8, which when reduced is 1/4. So once I know what my rise, my run are, I know my slope. Once I know my slope and my y-intercept, I could go ahead and write the equation of the line. Y equals mx plus b. Y is equal to, m is my slope, so my slope is 1/4. X. My y-intercept is positive 5. And there's the equation of my line. Now, that's reading the information off a graph. What if we didn't have a graph? What if we had the following? What if we had a list of x and y values? Our list of x and y values were the following: negative 6, negative 11, negative 2, negative 3, 0, and 1. Could you write the equation of a line? Just given a table of x and y values? Could you find out what the slope and the y-intercept were from a series of x and y coordinates? And of course the answer is yes. The first thing, and probably the easiest thing to find off of this table of x and y values, is the y-intercept. The y-intercept is the place on the graph where a line touches the y-axis. And it's always in the form of 0 and whatever the y-value is. This is the coordinate 0, the x-coordinate is 0, and the y-coordinate is however many places up on the y-axis. So when you're looking at a table of y-values, you're looking to see which point on this table of y values has an x coordinate of 0. Because if the x coordinate is 0, that means the y coordinate is going to be the y intercept. So just looking at this graph, and just looking at this table of xy values, I can tell that my y intercept is right here. This is when x is 0, what is my y? That's the definition of a y intercept. When x is 0, what is my y? So in this case, my y-intercept is 0, 1. So in my equation, y equals mx plus b, I don't know what my m is yet, but I know that my b is plus 1. Now I have to figure out what my slope is. Well, if you remember what we did yesterday, we were able to calculate what the slope of a line was by taking the y-coordinates of 2 points and putting that in the numerator because that signified the rise, and putting that over the change in the x-coordinates. And doing this arithmetic computation, you would be able to find the slope of a line. So do I have 2 points here? I most certainly do. So let's first designate, and I'll use these 2 points. They're probably the smallest numbers to work with. I'm going to call this one point 1 and this one point 2. So I'm now going to take the y-coordinate for point 2, which is 1. And I'm going to subtract from that the y coordinate for point 1, which is minus 3. And I'm going to put that over the x coordinate for point 2, which is 0, minus the x coordinate for point 1, which is negative 2. And I get 1 minus a minus 3 is really 1 plus 3, over 0 minus a minus 2 is really 0 plus 2. So then I get 4 over 2, which is simply 2. And there it is. My slope is 2. And I can take that and plug it into my equation of a line. So the equation of this line with this list of values for x and y is y equals 2x plus 1. And you may be saying to yourself, well, how do I know that's true? That's a whole lot of algebra, but I can't picture that in my head. Well, let's do a graph and let me show you how graphically, in fact, this is correct. Okay, so I'm going to work straight off my table, and I'm going to graph the points negative 2, negative 3 is right down here. And then I'm going to graph the point 0, 1, which is right there. And I'm going to count my rise over run. My rise is from here. My rise is here. So I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4. My rise is 4. And my run is from here to here, which is 2. So my slope is equal to my rise over run, which is 4 over 2, which is simply 2. So just from graphing the points, I was able to count the boxes and find that my slope was 2 plus x, and then just knowing the definition of a y-intercept, the point 0, 1 is the y-intercept. So there, I've checked it out graphically, and it does work. Let's do one more. Given the following table of values, can you tell me what the slope of this line is? I'm sorry. Given the following x and y values, can you write the equation of the line based on these x and y coordinates? Okay. So to write the equation of the line, I know I have to write an equation in the form of y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. When I do this problem, it's always easiest to try and find the y-intercept first. The y-intercept is always the coordinate that starts off with 0 as the x. And then I have to see how many places I either go up or down on the y. When I look at my table of x values, where is my x value 0? My x value is 0 right here, which means that the corresponding y value is negative 9. So that means my y-intercept is 0, negative 9. The next thing I need to now find is my slope.
Slope can be found
using the formula, the change of y's over the change of x's.
It doesn't matter which two points you use, but you can use any two points on this xy table.
So for the heck of it, I'm going to use 90 as point 1, and I'll use 89 as point 2. So plugging that into our slope equation, the y-coordinate for point 2 is 9, minus the y-value for coordinate 1, which is 0, over the x-value of point 2, which is 18, minus the x-value for point 1, which is 9. 9 minus 0 is 9, over 18 minus 9, which is 9. 9 over 9 gives me 1. So therefore, my slope is 1.
Once I have my y-intercept and once I have my slope, I can now write the equation of the line.
Y equals mx plus b.
Y equals, my slope is 1 times x.
My y-intercept is negative 9,
but I really don't have to write 1 as a coefficient for x, so I'm simply going to write y equals x minus 9. Okay, girls, that's the end of the lesson. Your homework will be posted on the website. Have a good night.